Hi, this is Mike Lawless, and in this video, I'll discuss the GastroPlus optimization module, and I'll also perform tutorial 5.4.1. The optimization module within GastroPlus optimizes model parameters to minimize the difference between the predicted and the observed PK values. A few examples of model parameters that can be optimized are the percent fluid in the colon, absorption scale factors, bile salt solubility ratio, particle radius, and Vmax. PK values that can be minimized include the Cp-time curve, or the fit to the Cp-time curve, fraction absorbed, oral bioavailability, area under the curve, Cmax and Tmax, and tissue concentration data for PBPK models. Three primary uses of the optimization module are model building, deconvolution, and design. The optimization module can be used in model building to calibrate simulation models to match your own specific data sets. For example, if you had a congeneric series of compounds that had measured fraction absorbed in rat, you could use the optimization module to optimize the absorption scale factors to best fit the fraction absorbed for these molecules. With deconvolution, you can find the best values for a variety of parameters to match measured oral plasma concentration time for a single drug. With design, you can optimize values for dose, dose interval, or particle size or particle density. And we'll show an example of optimizing the dose in the tutorial. This slide describes the steps involved in performing an optimization. First, you'll build your database or create the database. This includes importing the molecule and the parameters such as solubility and also the observed values. The next step is to select the parameters or the values to modify. Here you'll be prompted to optimize the parameters for a single record or for all records. And this would be useful in the example I just discussed for the congeneric series where you want to optimize the absorption scale factors. The next step is to select the objective function weights. This is the function that you're minimizing. This is the difference between the predicted and the observed values. And this can be used to balance high and low data points. I'll talk a little bit more about this in the next few slides. The next thing to select is your observation weights. Different observations can be weighted differently. So for example, you could weight the oral bioavailability different than the Cmax. And then the final one is to select lower and upper bounds for the parameters that be optimized and also the PK parameters. And again, I'll show examples of this. These two dialog boxes will be presented for the parameters to optimize. On the left, I show optimizing values for a PBPK model, and on the right for a compartmental model. And you'll notice that some of the PBPK tabs on the left are not shown on the right here, and that's simply because these aren't involved in the compartmental model. So the parameters to optimize are broken up into the ACAT parameters for the compound parameters, formulation, pharmacokinetics, and then the PBPK tissues, compound, and then metabolism and transporter properties. Once you select your values, you can go on to next. That will bring up the following dialog box. The objective function weights can be specified at the top of this dialog box. If we were to select unity, this would mean that there are no weightings, and this is called ordinary least squares. This favors data points with high values. So for example, if one is optimizing the CP time profile, then high values, e.g. near the Cmax, will be favored versus low values, for example, at the termination phase of the compound. To adjust by this, you might divide by a value of the data point. And so these are the options 1 over y, where y is the observed value, or y squared. This will compensate for the differences in the values. The other option here is to weight by the predicted values, y hat or y hat squared. And the reason reason you would want to do this is because the experimental values might be a little bit more rougher than the predicted values, and so scaling by the predicted values will tend to smooth that out. In the lower portion of the dialog box are the observation weights for the compound. Here, the units on the PK parameters are different. So fraction absorbed is simply a fraction, so that would go from 0 to 1, whereas the concentration profile might be in micrograms per milliliter, which would be larger values. So if you were optimizing both these, you might want to weight the fraction absorbed, which has lower values, higher than the concentration time profile. Then here, if we click next, it will display this dialog box where you can set the lower and the upper bounds for the parameter to be optimized. And then once you click next, then you'll look at the simulation bounds. And this is used in order to keep these values in reasonable ranges here for the optimization. This slide discusses the two examples in the tutorial. First, I'll show example one, which is optimizing the dose of BrickDest to achieve a desired Cmax. So the initial dose of 10 milligram yields a Cmax of 3.3 nanograms per milliliter. And we want to optimize the dose in order to achieve a Cmax of 10 nanograms per milliliter. In the second example, we'll calibrate an absorption model based on an observed Cp time profile. So we'll optimize the absorption scale gradient coefficients C1 through C4 in order to better match the observed Cp time profile. In the first tutorial, we will use a record in the gas demo database. Now, since you can't write to this gas demo database, the first thing I'm going to do is save the database under a different name in a local directory. So I go under the File, Save menu, Save Drug Database As, and then navigate to the directory where I want to save the file. And this is just a local file on my disk. I'll call it, it's called a GP folder. And it'll be called gasdemo0.mdb. So we'll save that. Now let's go to the BrickDest record. We see that the dose is 10 milligrams, and we'll go into the simulation tab and perform a simulation. So with the 10 milligram dose, the fraction absorbed is 68%, and the Cmax is 3.3 times 10 to the minus 3 micrograms per milliliter. Now let's say we want to optimize the dose so that we achieve a Cmax of 10 nanograms per milliliter, or 0.01 micrograms per milliliter. So we would go into the pharmacokinetics tab and set the Cmax to 0.01. That's the value we want to achieve. Then if we go under the database and save this drug record, it will save that value in there, and then go into the modules, optimization, and select the parameters and the objective function. So here we want to optimize a formulation parameter, and that is the initial dose. So this is just a simple optimization, and then we click next. Now at this point, the program will inform us that this parameter is part of the database, and as the optimization progresses, these values will be written to the database, so you might want to make a backup copy. Now we've already done that because we've saved the initial gas demo database as a new file, so we won't need to do that at this point. You can do it after this is finished, so you can set up the optimization and then save the database. This next dialog box is for the optimization, so we're just going to stick with the function of 1 over y hat squared, and then we want to set the objective weight function for Cmax to 1, and set all the other values to 0. So now we can go on to next. This specifies the bounds for the initial dose or for the dose. The initial value is 10, which was already in the database. The lower bound 0, and the upper bound is 1 times 10 to the 6. Let's set that down a little bit to 10 to the 3 so that we won't get a dose of over 1 gram. And then click Next. Here's where we could set initial bounds. I'm not going to change any of those at this point. So we'll click Finish. So that's set up the optimization. Now if we go into the Simulation tab, this dialog box now contains a button that says Optimize. And if we click on the Optimize button, it will first prompt us to save a text file. This will be the results of the optimization and the inputs. So we'll click save. It gives us a brief profile or preview of the file. We'll go ahead and click OK, and it will start the optimization. And we'll just let this proceed. As you see, the initial value is 10, and it's increasing that pretty rapidly up into the 20s and now into the 30s. So we'll let that just go ahead and continue until it's found an optimized value. So the optimization has converged. So we simply click OK. Once we click OK, again, it'll show the output file. We click OK, and then we're going to go ahead and save those, save the final result into the database. So now if we go into the compound tab, the initial dose is now 48.4 milligrams. Let's go ahead and perform a simulation there and look at the results. So with the higher initial dose, we have a lower fraction absorbed. That's normal for low solubility compound, and the Cmax is 0.01 or 10 nanograms per milliliter, and that's what we wanted to achieve. So in order to achieve this Cmax, you would have to increase the dose to 48 milligrams. In the second example, I'm going to optimize the absorption scale coefficients of a molecule in order to better fit the observed data. So in this example, there's a database called Test Drug that I've copied into a local directory. And along with that, you also have to copy the OPD file, which contains the experimental values. So I've copied both those files into a local directory. We're going to be performing an optimization. That's going to change the coefficients, and we'll save them in the database. So I'm going to save this database under a new name, and just use the default name testdrug0.mdb. So that saves it, and then now we're working on the database that it was saved to. So we'll go into the simulation tab. Let's first take a look at the absorption scale factors here. These are going to be the values that we'll be optimizing. These are the default values. Go into the simulation and start the simulation. And if you look at the results, you see that our Tmax is a little bit lower than the observed values. So we're about 45 minutes off on that. And then the area under the curve is underpredicted compared to the observed values. And we can look at the graph for this, and you see that the predicted curve here cuts off and doesn't quite go to a high enough value and then extend out in here. So we want to optimize the absorption scale coefficients to better fit this curve. So we would go under the modules tab under the optimization and select the parameters to optimize. That will bring up this dialog box. Here's the test compound we'll be working on. And again, we could change it. If we had multiple records here, this is where we would change to optimize them across all the records in the database. We're going to be changing the ACAT compound properties here. So we're going to optimize these four coefficients here and then click Next. It prompts us that these are part of the database. We've already made a copy here, so there's no reason to recopy it. We're going to again use the 1 over y hat squared value and just leave the default here, which is the concentration time objective function. We click Next. This gives the lower and upper bounds for the values here. And again, we could adjust these upper bounds. I'm just going to leave them The same here, and then go into next and finished. Again, I'm not going to change the simulation bounds. Now we can go into the simulation tab and click optimize. It's going to prompt us for the file to save. I'll call it again optest.txt, and then go ahead and click OK to begin the simulation. So here we see the current values, and then the R-squared. Initially it was very low at 0.5, and you see how quickly it updates once it starts optimizing these coefficients. So again, I'll just let this continue, keeping an eye on the overall R-squared value. You want it above 0.9. Okay, this seems to be looking pretty good, so I'm going to halt the optimization. By clicking on this button, then it says it was halted. I'll click OK, and this gives us the parameters. Now we click OK, and here it prompts us to save the optimized parameters. We're going to click yes, and this prompts us for the physiology to save. So we'll call this test drug. So this is a new physiology, so it's got the new coefficients. We click OK. And then it asks us if we want to set this new physiology in the database, and we'll click yes. So what that's done is under the gut physiology tab, now we have the physiology as test drug. Let's go ahead and perform a simulation with these updated coefficients. Now here we overestimate the Tmax a little bit, but you see that the area under the curve is better matched between the experimental and the predicted values. If we go under the graph tab, now we see that the curve is going better through these points here by optimizing those coefficients. This slide just summarizes what we've discussed during this video. The GastroPlus optimization model optimizes user-selected parameters to better match the observed values. Compound and physiological parameters can be optimized. There are several objective function choices. You can also specify the weights for the observed values and the lower and upper bounds for the optimized parameters and the simulation. Just want to thank everyone for watching this video. If you have any questions, please send me an email at mlawless@simulations-plus.com. Thank you.